Have you used electricity today? Do you know where it comes from? In New Mexico, most of our power production comes from coal and natural gas. Despite our abundance of wind and sun, only 7% come from these renewable sources. Nationally, the ratio is different, but two-thirds of our electricity still comes from fossil fuels. It's not a sustainable formula. Over the last 800,000 years, carbon dioxide in our atmosphere stayed below 280 parts per million until we, in this age of fossil fuel consumption, pushed it higher. Since the start of the Industrial Revolution 250 years ago, carbon dioxide in the atmosphere has increased by 40% to over 400 parts per million. Along with other greenhouse gases such as methane, high levels of carbon dioxide are raising the temperature of the Earth's atmosphere and oceans, bringing on a host of challenges, from extreme weather to rising sea levels to widespread species extinction. If the data reveals the negative impact of our actions, and there's virtual consensus in the scientific community that it does, how do we transform our lives to create a culture of sustainability, one that respects future generations and the great diversity of life on this planet? As a photographer, I strive to create work that informs our perceptions of how humans use and transform the Earth, focusing my attention on the intersections of nature and human activity, places that, for me, provide great visual, environmental, and political intrigue. My current project, Changing Perspectives, looks at renewable energy development mostly from an aerial perspective. In October 2010, before construction commenced, I began photographing over the future site of Ivanpah Solar, a concentrated solar power plant in the Mojave Desert of California. How do most power plants work? They're just giant tea kettles. Whether nuclear, coal, natural gas, or geothermal, water is superheated to drive steam turbines to generate electricity. Concentrated solar works the same way. Large mirrors focus the sun's energy to accomplish the same task. In February 2014, Ivanpah Solar became the world's largest concentrated solar power plant. With over 300,000 mirrors on 3,500 acres of federal land, it can produce 392 megawatts of electricity. Compared with power from natural gas, Ivanpah reduces carbon dioxide emissions by 400,000 tons per year while making enough power for 140,000 American homes. Now, 4 years ago, as the first marks were made for Ivanpah, I had no idea how this solar plant would come to exemplify some of the challenges we face on the road to sustainability. Along with energy conservation and efficiency, distributed generation, and smart grid technology, large renewable energy projects can displace coal and natural gas as part of the reliable electricity supply we expect and demand. By several measures, this desert basin, already impacted by human development, is a prime place for renewable energy. Ivanpah is sited along Interstate 15 on the California-Nevada border, near a golf resort, a dirt racetrack, photovoltaic and natural gas power plants, and the casino community of Prim. But the basin is also habitat for the desert tortoise, a species listed as threatened under the Federal Endangered Species Act. So to mitigate this issue, before construction began, Ivanpah biologists carefully removed 173 adult and juvenile tortoises for study and eventual relocation. To date, Ivanpah's partners have spent over $22 million to research and care for the tortoises, and may spend an additional $34 million to meet federal and state obligations. Ironically, the desert tortoise in Mojave may be better understood and ultimately protected than before Ivanpah. Ivanpah is also addressing the issue of avian mortality. All wind and solar projects face this issue. Some would argue, if renewable energy projects kill birds, they should not be built. But let's put the issue in perspective. It's estimated that 600 million birds die in the US each year just by hitting buildings and houses. And another estimate, up to 8 million die from coal power generation. If 1,500 birds die each year at Ivanpah, the high-end estimate based on 7 months of data collection, how do we weigh this number against our overall impact on birds? A recent study estimated that bird deaths per gigawatt hour of electricity are 17 times higher for fossil fuel than they are for wind power. And while comprehensive data is not yet available for concentrated solar, the numbers appear to be much closer to wind than to fossil fuel. So why am I telling you all this? I value renewable energy, tortoises, and birds. The reality is, most human activity has both positive and negative consequences. The impacts of our endeavors, in this case, renewable energy, always have both local and big picture consequence. The conundrum posed by the contradiction between these two has polarized the environmental community and led to some unlikely and unwitting alliances between environmental preservationists and anti-renewable, pro-fossil fuel advocates. Our current social and political structures encourage discourse and polarization instead of cultivating solutions and consensus. And polarization leads to paralysis. To create a path forward, we need to evaluate the pros and cons of our options and then make proactive decisions to create a path forward. Because if we're looking for an option that is completely good, with no downside, we'll never find it. Since the start of the Industrial Revolution and the Age of Oil, our human population has grown from under 1 billion to over 7 billion. We have become, by default, stewards of the Earth's ecosystem. Renowned dancer and choreographer Martha Graham once said, "Every moment of choice is a sacrifice." But what I prefer is this: each moment of choice is both a sacrifice and an opportunity. As human beings, we have the capacity to learn from the consequences of our past actions and then apply this knowledge to anticipate the future consequences of our present actions. What shall we do in this moment of choice? Focus only on the sacrifices, or energetically embrace our opportunities?